Los Angeles. For the millions who live, work, and play in the greater Los Angeles basin, there's no other place like it. We love LA for its beautiful beaches, Mediterranean climate, rich culture, and world-class entertainment. It's also one of the few places in the world where you can surf and ski on the same day because local mountains are so close to the coast. The LA Basin is enclosed to the north by the San Gabriel Mountains. The San Gabriels are characterized by steep slopes, which cause the rock and soil to fall off the face of the mountain through a natural process called erosion. Trees, plants, and shrubs play a major part in erosion because their roots hold rock and soil in place. But vegetation is also a fuel source for wildfires. When a wildfire occurs, vegetation is burned away, exposing rocks and soil to the elements and making them even more vulnerable to erosion. Then the rain comes. It doesn't rain often in LA, but when it does, it can be very intense. In fact, some of the highest rainfall amounts in California have occurred in the San Gabriel Mountains. During intense rainstorms, stormwater carries loose soil and rocks downstream. The largest material settles out first in the alluvial fan. Most of the remaining material settles out within the floodplains, while only the smallest sediment is transported to the coast. This process is called the sediment cycle. At the turn of the century, development began expanding to the regions of alluvial fans and floodplains. When large, intense storms occurred, stormwater and sediment would cascade down the mountains into developed areas, occasionally causing catastrophic toll on life and property. In 1915, the state legislature formed the Los Angeles County Flood Control District. The district's mission is to manage the risk of flooding and capture and store rainfall to replenish groundwater basins. To reduce the risk of flooding and mudslides, a series of dams and debris basins were built in the foothills. A dam is a barrier built across rivers and streams designed to limit the amount of water moving downstream. Dams reduce the risk of flooding for downstream communities by allowing the district to release water in controlled amounts. Dams also help the district retain rainwater. Holding water behind the dam creates large lakes called reservoirs. When the district releases water from the reservoirs, it moves through a system of open channels into spreading grounds where it is allowed to recharge groundwater basins. Groundwater is a valuable source of local drinking water and meets the water supply demands for a third of the households in Los Angeles County. Debris basins are similar to dams but work on a much smaller scale. Debris basins capture the sediment, rocks, boulders, and vegetation that are washed down the mountains during a major storm, but they still allow water to flow downstream. They are the last line of defense against mudslides and debris flow for communities downstream. Back to our sediment cycle. The San Gabriel Mountains are constantly eroding because of soil type, weather, and wildfires. But this natural system was modified by the flood control system. When it rains, erosion still occurs, but instead of sediment collecting in rivers and spreading out in the alluvial fan and floodplains, it is captured within dams and debris basins. To keep the system functioning properly, sediment must be routinely removed. If sediment isn't cleaned out of the system, more and more sediment builds up behind dams and provides less and less capacity to hold back the stormwater and sediment. Eventually, the dam can fill up, overtop, and flood the downstream communities. Think of it like this. A dam or debris basin functions similar to a bathtub. The bathtub is filled with water and slowly drains out. But if sand was also added to the bathtub would plug, eventually overflow, and create a really messy bathroom. The Los Angeles County Flood Control District has provided flood risk management for almost 100 years. However, new challenges associated with sediment management have emerged. Attention is being paid to the environmental impacts from sediment management, and opportunities are being explored for the beneficial reuse of sediment. The district is always open to discussing and hearing new ideas, so please share your ideas and find out how to be involved at lasedimentmanagement.com.